Hi, so I will be talking about automatic plankton classification using deep CNNs. So why do we care about plankton classification? So planktons are essential for the ecological systems. The current methods for measuring and monitoring plankton population requires an expert to label the underwater images manually. So we want to automate this process. We are using a data set provided by Hatfield Marine Science Center. It has 30,000 training images and 130,000 test images. There are 121 different plankton classes. So it is really skewed data set which just has 30,000 training images. As you can see, these are the types of images present in the data set. These are a number of images. So each image contains one plankton. These are black and white images, and they are around 100 by 100 pixels in size. So CNNs have been performed well on image classification, so we decided to use them for our problem. But the problem with CNNs is they have a large number of parameters. For example, if this simple three-layered convolutional neural network has more than 100,000 parameters, but we just have 30,000 training images. So to increase the training images or to reduce the overfitting, we use data augmentation. So we tried various ways to augment the data. These are rotation, translation, scaling, and perspective warping. Also, we do an online data augmentation in which every iteration for training the new neural network, each image is randomly rotated, translated, scaled, and warped before giving it to the new neural network. So AlexNet in computer vision community has been shown to perform well on various image classification tasks. So we decided to start with this data, with this architecture. So we use CAFE for all our implementation. We don't have test labels with us, so the test labels sit on a test server. So we have to upload our prediction on that test server, and that test server uses multi-class log loss. As you can see, with AlexNet, we are able to get a twofold improvement over the random forest baseline provided by the test server. But the problem with log loss is it's not very intuitive. So we decided to evaluate our system using accuracy, but the test server doesn't calculate accuracy. So for that, we divided our train set into two sets. We use 90% of our train set to train the network and 10% as a validation to see. So you can see that the AlexNet just performs 50% accuracy, so there is a lot of room for improvement. So we decided to build our own architectures. So we use architectures similar to OxfordNet. So we built three architectures which are in increasing depth. So the first architecture, A1, has four learnable layers, as can be seen in the red colors. Then A2 has seven layers, as can be seen in red and green, and A3 has 10 layers, as can be seen in red, green, and blue. So with A3, we get a 16.5% improvement over AlexNet in terms of accuracy, and around approximately fourfold improvement over the baseline random forest. So now our next step is to make an ensemble of these networks and also tried a recently proposed activation layer called parametrically rectified linear unit. Thank you.